So today's video is going to be very different from the other videos which I normally make. In today's video, I'm going to talk about 5 different ways to reuse your old devices. So many of us would be having a lot of old devices, right? So you might be thinking how to use them, or you might be just keeping them somewhere else. So for those people, this is very simple and effective way to reuse them. It is also giving advantage to nature, because by throwing this, you're like increasing the plastic and etc. So this is also very good and eco-friendly in one way. So let's begin. Number 1, display alarm clocks or display clocks. So this is the simplest and very effective method to reuse your old devices. With KLWP, you can actually make nice clock designs on your tab or mobile phone. And also, this can help you start a new routine. And also, you don't need to waste battery when you're keeping an alarm, because nowadays, alarm clocks are starting to drain a little bit of battery. So now let's go to number two, digital photo frames. So this one is very easiest, and you don't need any application unless you're transferring pictures. By doing this, you don't need to add physical photo frames, and you can keep on changing the photos from family photos to superhero photos or game photos and etc. And also, by doing this, you can actually give a nice touch or decoration to your room or your hall or any place where you keep this. Now let's go to number three, ebook. So this is the most common and also one of the best way to use your old tab or mobile phones. You can actually download ebooks from PDF drive, though I don't recommend them. And also, you can use Red Era app if you are having PDF files. Like for example, the NCERT books come in PDF. So by doing this, you can actually get a digital book or ebook basically, which you can change, and also worth than getting a real Kindle, which is very costly. Though there are some difference, like the battery things and etc. Okay, so let's go to number four. An all-in-one nostalgic gaming console. So for those people who like to play or who used to play classic games, let it be the Sega games, the Mortal Kombat 1, the God of War, Ghost of Sparta and many more, this might be one of your favorites. So actually, you can use your old devices, and they can run technically those games, because those devices are having stronger RAM and also strong capability also. So basically, you can just download emulators like the Dolphin emulator, the PPSSPP and many more, and download the custom ROMs. Not custom, actually, they are sometimes custom, but you can use the real ROMs, which you can get it from Wim's Lair. You can go check it out. Now let's go to number 5, and also the last one. Number 5, rooting or jailbreaking. So rooting in Android or jailbreaking in iOS is a double-edged sword. So by doing this, you can either lose your OS or lose security and many more, or you can actually download custom softwares. You can control your mobile phone. So basically, by rooting, you can access your mobile phone's internal data like OS, and also you can control your Google apps, you can mod your device in such a way that it can be very useful to you. So basically, by rooting or jailbreaking, you will lose security and warranty. So even after you remove the root option, you will still lose your security and warranty, since you have already came back and also you have already went. So I don't prefer rooting a lot, but for those people who like to do it, you can go. But I would like to suggest you to watch some videos on rooting and jailbreaking. And for those people who know, who are XDA developers or XDA forums, you can surely do that. So I hope you like this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I'll meet you guys in the next video. Till then, bye.